Hello everyone! What I already mentioned in my previous video, I'm still not happy with the look of my painting, so I'm going to work on it a little bit more. I'm going to add some texture and also some nice sparkle. I'm also going to color the texture paste, and I will also put a link in the description box of how I make the texture paste. And what you're also going to see in this video is I'm adding a fourth layer of resin. And at the end you will see a close-up of the end result. So for the new people to my channel and like tutorials about resin or acrylic and experiments, you are at the right place. Please consider to subscribe. Click the notification bell because that way you don't miss anything. So I already started with adding some texture to my painting, and I make this texture paste myself out of marble dust and an acrylic binder. I will add the links to those supplies in the description box. It's a very cheap paste, and it's a one-to-one ratio, so one part acrylic binder and one part marble dust. And yeah, you can make some nice textures with this paste. So I mix those two parts together, and then I'm adding it to my painting with a palette knife. You can see it. And with my palette knife, I'm making some nice textures in the paste, but you can also make it flat if you want to. But I think this will give it the painting a nice look. I like combining different mediums together, and also textures. And I did more paintings with this texture paste. I will also put those links in the description box or in the right corner. And there you also can see how I mix the paste, but also how I color it. You will also see parts of that in this video, but I made more videos of that, so I will add the links. And by using the hairdryer onto your texture paste, then you can create some nice cracks. You can also buy crackle paste, but that's very expensive. And yeah, I like the cracks with what I can create with this method much more than the crackle paste, because this looks much more natural, and I like that a lot. So you need to put the hairdryer as long on it till it's dry, because then it will crack. And I have it on a low speed and very close to the paste. You can see it in the close-up. You can see it much better than the cracks than you can see now. So if you are curious, then you can wait until the end of the video. And what I already mentioned, I'm also going to color it, and I'm using the Arteza pearl paints again. This is the purple violet color. And I'm also using an acrylic binder together with the paint, because I'm diluting it with a lot of water. And we all know if you dilute it with water, then the color, the pigments will separate, and that's why I'm using an acrylic binder. You can see it on my plate. And also with acrylic binder you can make your paint more transparent, because I don't want to color it with a vibrant color. I also want to see the texture of the paste still through the paints. So that's why I'm using water and an acrylic binder. After that I'm using a paper towel to take away some paint, but the paint will stay in the cracks, so that's good. I like that. Again, and in between layers, I'm drying it with a hairdryer. That way you can work much faster. So again, I'm adding the purple color. Again, using the paper towel. And again, I dried the layer with my hairdryer. Now I'm adding a different color. It's also an Arteza paint. It's a hot pink color. And again, I'm using my paper towel to take away some paint, but not all. All the supplies I use in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box. So if you're curious, then you can check out the description box. I've also added all the links in the description box. Now I'm using a nice glitter that I'm testing. It's a very fine red color, and I mixed it in some diamond glaze glue. I like that glue very much. It dries clear, so you won't see it anymore. And in some places I'm adding this sparkle, this glitter. Spreading it with my finger, and now I'm drying it again with my hair dryer. And with some white paint, I'm adding highlights. And I've not diluted this paint, it's straight out of the jar. And with a brush that I hold flat onto the surface, I'm adding the highlights. And for the Arteza paints, I am an affiliate of Arteza. That means that if you buy through my links, I earn a little bit of money out of that, and that's great because that helps me to buy the supplies. I also have a discount code of 10%. It's in the description box. It's PetraJungbloed1. So if you use that code, then you get 10% off of your order. So that's great. Now I'm using a very light shade of blue, which is sky blue, also Arteza acrylic paint. Again, I've diluted it with some water and acrylic binder to make it transparent. And I do the same process. Use a paper towel to take away some paint. And I dried it in between with my hairdryer again, and now I'm adding the second layer to it. And what I already mentioned in the previous video, I'm not totally satisfied with it, so that's why I'm searching for myself for a way to make it look more interesting. And at this point I'm still not happy. So, yeah, maybe that will change if we go through the process. Now I'm adding again some glitter. I mixed two different glitters together. I'm using the Halo Silver by Just Resin. Very nice glitter, holographic. but also a nice white holographic glitter that I'm testing, because I also want to sell some nice glitters in my Etsy shop, just as I do with my mica pigments. And yeah, I'm testing these glitters to see how they look. So with a brush I apply it onto the texture paste, and I hope when I add the resin layer that it will sparkle beautiful. You all know I love sparkle, so yeah, there needs to be something in it. Yeah, and what I also mentioned is that I started with this painting with a swipe technique. You could see very good how I do the swipe technique. I was not happy with that, and now if you look at the painting, it's totally different. So that's not bad, because you can save your painting if you are not happy with the look of it. And it doesn't matter that it changes. Again, I'm adding the highlights with the white paint. You can see that I hold my brush flat to the surface, so only the higher parts will get this paint. And then I'm almost done with this part of the painting, so I need to let this dry before I can start on the fourth resin layer. So I'm going to start on the fourth resin layer, and I'm starting with one of my own natural mica pigments. It's the white lily. I have a lot of white colors, but this is the color that has that has almost no sparkle. And I'm adding it next to the texture paste. And I made it a little bit more transparent, so that you can see the colors underneath through it. And I'm pushing it against my texture paste. Yeah, and the painting still looks out of balance, so I'm trying to fix that in this part of the painting, of the video. Adding more of the white lily. Also some clear. And of course also resin on top of my texture paste. And now I'm spreading it with my stirring stick. And I still have the winter in my mind. What I see, the colors I see when I think about winter. So it's still is white, and also some different shades of blue and pink. So that's what I'm going to use in this layer. Again, a white color, but then a different one. This is the Resitint Max Titanium White. It's a very opaque white color. Pushing it against my texture paste. And what I also want to create is some depth and maybe some nice cells. in this part of the painting. I'm also going to use the Bombay ink again. This is the turquoise color, so it's transparent, so you will see the colors underneath through it. And that's good, because that way you can create some depth. I'm pushing it against my texture paste. Oh no, the white color I've added. And I will let them bleed into each other. Spreading it with my stirring stick again. A little bit more. And now by heating it, I try to blow the white over the blue. And I also tilt my board a little bit. Adding a nice dark blue color on top of the ink. And on top of that, a little bit of the white. And I'm going to use my heat gun again to blend those colors. Again, I'm tilting my board. There you can see it. Also to see what kind of effects I can create with this. This is the Bombay ink magenta, and I mixed one of my own natural mica pigments in it. It's the sparkle white. Gives a nice sparkle to the color. I like that. If you want more information about my own natural mica pigments, you can find it in the description box. They are also available in the USA and Canada by my associate Evelyn Schaefer. So if you're curious, then you can check out the description box. Adding some white on top and also a nice pink color. There you can see it. And again, I'm using the heat gun to blend those colors, blow them to the outside. This is the Bombay ink teal. It's transparent, so you will see the lacing of the layer underneath through it, so that's good. A little bit of the dark blue on top of it, and some white. And then again, I'm going to blend those colors to see what kind of effects I can create. adding a little bit more white next to the texture paste. And again, I'm going to use the heat gun to blow the white into the blue. And I'm getting some nice lacing on top of the dark blue color. Yeah, I'm almost at the end of the working time of my resin, so I'm using a stirring stick to make lines in the resin. And when you are at the end of the working time, the lines will stay much better. They don't flow that much anymore. Now I'm adding more of the titanium white, because I want to have more of those lines to resemble the snow or the ice or whatever. There you can see it, making lines. But I'm not going to cover it up totally, because I still want to see parts of the layer underneath through it. And that's why I'm making the lines. Yeah, in the close-up at the end of this video, you can see it much better. Yes, I'm almost done with the fourth layer, and yeah, it looks totally different, but that's what I already mentioned. That's no problem if you can save your painting. So this is the end result. I'm very pleased how it looks now, because I was not happy with it, and it looks much better. So I will show you all a close-up. There you can see the texture paste that I also colored with the Arteza paint. There you can see the lines I made, but also you can see still the layer underneath through it. There's some nice lacing with a nice dark blue color. Yes, and it sparkles a lot, so that's great. That's because of the sparkle white. So I'm really happy how this one turns out. I like the texture paste and yeah, the total look of the painting. So let me know what you think. And I hope you liked the process of showing you all my mistakes and how I save my painting. Let me know if you liked that process. So all the materials I've used in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with all the links to the websites. So if you're curious, then you can check that out. You can see the nice glitter there that I added, so it gives a nice sparkle. Again, the lacing up close, but also the texture paste. Information about my own natural mica pigments you can also find in the description box, but also the Arteza paints with the links to it. And the link to my influencers, Amazon store, but also my Etsy shop and my Instagram and Facebook page. So all the information you want to know is in the description box. So let me know what you think of this painting, and if you like it or not, please give me a thumbs up for this video if you like what I'm doing, and consider to subscribe if you haven't. And I want to thank you all for watching again, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!